Okay guys, one thing I forgot, the screws are again. There's two tapped out holes here on the side of the engine block. Well, they're designed for the flywheel magnet. And I put the motor mount in the way without putting this in place. But I'm going to see if I can get it on with the motor mount in the way. Seems I should be able to, but it fits right on there like that, if you can see it. And there's these little tiny screws, and it's also adjustable. So on another segment I'm gonna have to figure out how to time this, because it does move enough to be out of time. And these are Phillips. These are Phillips screws, not hex heads. And there's a little flex to it, so get them started first. And almost lost a little washer. There's like a little Phillips screw and a lock washer on here. I was going to say, I don't think there's enough room in the motor mount anyways to handle it. So, I think I'm safe. I don't think it was going to be routed through. But I'm just going to snug them. Because it does actually move a little bit side to side here. It's like a slight adjustment on it. So I'll have to talk to some folks, and there is a slight adjustment on here to line it up. And if I take the cylinder lock out, if you see the magnet, there's the magnet right there. So that's got to be in the firing position for the magnet. So I will find out about that and let you know. But that's the CDI ignition wire, and I don't see a place it can be routed through the engine, so I think you're safe bringing it up. Just the way that is, it wouldn't fit through here anyways. There's not enough room. There's not enough room to fish that wire anyway, so I was safe. But that's the CDI coil pickup, or whatever you want to call it, and that's all I wanted to show you. Until we get to stuffing this baby into the bird again. Alright, it's Cruiser Roy, and I'm out of here.